We're going to take you live to Melbourne now, where Foreign Minister Marise Payne is speaking after meeting with her Indian counterpart.
For a resilient, inclusive and prosperous Indo-Pacific. The relationship between our countries is most certainly at a high point. We've noted again today the wonderful step of the signing of the Comprehensive Strategic Partnership by Prime Ministers Morrison and Modi in June of 2020. Our discussion today on the challenges facing the region, on issues ranging from COVID response to economic recovery, maritime security, supply chain resilience and cyber threats, has underlined our shared common interests and values, including in democracy and in the rule of law. The relationship between Australia and India has deep connections in trade and investment as well. And as we speak, as we stand here in Melbourne, Minister Dan Tehan, Trade, Tourism and Investment Minister, is returning from India after a round of negotiations for the Comprehensive Economic Cooperation Agreement. This is an agreement which we are confident will unlock new trade and investment opportunities for both countries, particularly as our respective economies recover from the impact of COVID-19. I'm also proud, with a number of my Australian ministerial colleagues, to announce today a series of new initiatives to boost the education and cultural ties between Australia and India. The initiatives are appropriately called the Maitri, meaning friendship initiatives. Under the Maitri Scholars Program, the Australian government will provide over $11 million over 4 years to support Indian students to study at Australia's world-leading universities. The Maitri Fellowships Program will provide $3.5 million over 4 years to build links between future leaders. We'll support mid-career Australian and Indian professionals to collaborate on strategic research initiatives. We'll also provide over $6 million over 4 years under a program which I think is an absolutely fabulous initiative, the Maitri Cultural Partnerships, to support cultural exchanges and boost the role of the creative industries in our two countries. I must say, in our discussion of that today, I mentioned the Australia-India Youth Dialogue, which really has innovation and youth leadership, of course, at its core. But I have always been impressed with their engagement on cultural issues, creative issues in particular. Importantly, the Maitri program is a strong positive for the education sector in Australia, recovering from the economic impacts of COVID-19 as it is. It is also pleasing that Minister Tehan was able to sign a memorandum of understanding on tourism with his ministerial counterpart yesterday in New Delhi. Under the MOU, Australia and India will work together to promote travel between the two markets and advance cooperation on tourism policy, data sharing, training and industry engagement. I also announced with my ministerial colleagues the establishment of the Australia-India Infrastructure Forum. The forum will match Australian finance with the enormous infrastructure opportunities in India and its near neighbours. It will host workshops and generate analysis to drive results for businesses. Like the other parts of the relationship between Australia and India, which are many and varied, I look forward to seeing the Maitri program and the Australia-India Infrastructure Forum grow in the coming years.